In this video, you'll see how to connect your app to a database. Using a database makes your app even more powerful, dynamic, and easier to manage. You can connect your app to an internal or external database. In this video, we'll see together how to create a variable with PandaSuite database, how to connect to Airtable to display a collection, and add user authentication with Firebase. First, let's focus on how to create a variable, like a score, with PandaSuite database. PandaSuite database is the internal database to manage collections and variables within your application. Let's add a PandaSuite database to your project by clicking on the database icon. Open this database that has been added to your project and create a new property. As the score is a numeric data, let's choose the type number and the default value 0. You can modify the value of this variable from any action of the user interface. Here it's going to be when the user is selecting the right answer. Select the right answer and the action interact with the data provider. Select PandaSuite database and the action modifies the data. Choose the score variable. Select the increment function and the value is the number 1. To display the score, select a text block and add a data binding. Let's choose from data provider and the score variable. Now let's focus on how to display a collection from Airtable. You must have an Airtable account and create your own base. In your app, add an HTTP component that will implement the connection to the API of Airtable. Place it at the project level so that it is active throughout your screens. In the properties, add the URL of the API that you find in your Airtable API documentation. Use the API parameters provided by Airtable, such as the API key. Enter inside your component and test the request to make sure that data has been correctly set. In your screen, add a collection list component to display your collection and create your custom design for the list. As a source for the collection list component, connect to the right data using the data binding. Choose from a database, select your HTTP component and its records. Inside your collection component, you must select each element and connect it to the right source of data. For the title, add the data binding to its content. As the source of the collection has been determined, select Current Item Data and explore your Airtable data to select the right field. Now do the same with the arrondissement of Paris. Last things to do is to add an action when your project is launched to start the request to the HTTP component. Select the project and add an action to launch project event. Finally, let's see how to add user authentication with Firebase. Firebase is a mobile app development platform from Google. It helps you easily manage user session and authentication and also associate data to your user. You can create an account for free. First, let's add a Firebase session component to your project. In the property, let's add the API key and project ID available from your Firebase account. For more information about how to create a new project on Firebase and get those information, go to our dedicated article on learn.pandasuite.com. To display an authentication form, let's add an authentication component. This one must be linked to the Firebase session component. Choose it from the list. If you want to customize user workflow depending on if the user is signed in or not, select the Firebase session component and add an action. Choose the event user signed in to define where you will be heading after authentication, and the event user signed out to redirect him to the authentication screen. I hope this video tutorial was useful for you. Data is everywhere in PandaSuite Studio and you can manage it easily whether it comes from an internal or external source. Do not hesitate to go to learn.pandasuite.com to get additional resources based on your needs. In the next video, let's focus on the states.